So welcome to my channel, Sandhya. Yeah, it's been very long time that I did the video. Finally, our exams is done, so we are planning to do the video again. So she's, as you all know, Deepika. Tell me about your YouTube channel.
My YouTube channel is Desi to Pardesi. Please, if you don't know about it, please do watch it. Do subscribe and then
like, share, subscribe. Me too. Like, share, subscribe. And then I'm going to attach her YouTube channel in the description box.
Please do subscribe. Watch that.
Okay. So for the today's video, we are going to talk about our experience as an educare scholars. So first, we are going to talk about sending the documents to the university.
Yeah. We'll talk about that.
So how to send the documents to university? There are many courier services in India. You can send through any courier services. I sent it through the DHL. So for the documents, there is a student plan too, but you need to send three universities, isn't it?
No.
In the DHL?
No. So there is this thing, there is this student discount in DHL. I don't know if it's still there or not. So while we are applying, if we pay just 5,000, we can send three times.
Three times.
We can send it 3 times.
But since we are sending one time to the one university, we can go with the direct plan, no plans and all. It charged me like a 2,500 for sending documents to the Seoul Konkuk University.
One time. It reached in 7 days.
Yeah, mine is reached in more than before a week.
Yeah.
It's like it took me for 5 days or something, that's all. So
in my case, it was 7 days, and it depends upon the situations. For us, while we were sending, it was the lockdown period, so
yeah,
mine went little late. But if you want to, send sooner, you can choose the private, services, courier services. For example, FedEx or something. It's gonna, they are gonna charge you more, but still, you can send it in a faster way.
Yeah. For the selection of university, we are going to do the another video, so you can watch that video.
I actually made a recent YouTube video on that.
Yeah.
You can go and check that video. She's gonna attach that YouTube link.
Yeah, I'm gonna attach the YouTube link of it. Don't worry.
So sweet.
So university con. So after sending the documents, she had a problem with the document, so the university contacted her. So she has to send the document again. So for the birth certificate, I think so.
I had a problem with my birth certificate, so they just asked me to send it again,
yeah,
the original one. So I had to send one document again separately, just
one document. So 2,500 rupees.
And so if you have any documents missing in your previous courier, they're gonna send you an email. You have to send, they're gonna give you a specific
time period,
and then you have to send your document in that period of time.
So interview. Actually, many people are asking, Didi, did you have an interview? So actually, we don't have any interview. So don't think that we got it like that. Applications are actually good. We are not flattering ourselves, but it's true. Since we are an aerospace students, you guys may be understanding how many things we have to do as an aerospace student.
And the plus point is we had our research publications and a lot of internships and the workshops and a job experience, a little job experience. Kind of my yours is a full-time job experience, mine was part-time job experience.
Yeah. So also we had an internship in Air India Mumbai, so it
that was
played
an advantage.
Yeah, it's an advantage for us because Air India is a government one. So also we have something like a flying experience.
Yeah.
We actually didn't fly, but still we had an experience.
I had the flying experience. I was in NCC, so I had this flying experience. I was a co-pilot once.
Yeah.
So lucky to have
that. Yeah, she's an NCC cadet. So for the first round, within 1 month after you sending your application, you'll be getting the results. So our results got in April 30. So we were so excited to see our names in the notice board. It was wow.
I was actually sleeping at that time, and this woman called me at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and I was so shocked.
Okay, we'll tell you one thing. Actually, we actually think that both of us, only one will be selected because it's GKS first thing.
And,
so,
and second thing, we were from same major
same
and we applied to
same university. we also studied in the same undergraduate.
And we made a pinky promise that if one of us got selected, and next year they're gonna help so hard.
We were like,
if you get selected, please
take me.
You know, help me in the next time. If I get selected, I have to help for the next time. Yeah, we made a pinky swear, and I think universe was on our side. We both were selected to the same university and the same teacher. Yes.
So NIED. Actually, we don't know anything about the second round. Mm-hmm. We are three people from the same Konkuk University. We thought one will be both within one of them, and another will be another person. It's totally dependent on the university how many people they wanted to choose. So, but luckily, we made it.
Little Bollywood dance, yay!
Yay! So for the medical, actually they provide you the, so if your second round is done and then made your mind that you're going to Korea. So it's like medical.
Just make up your mind that you're coming to Korea, your scholarship is done once you know pass the second round, and rest is just the medical. If your health is fine, then I think everything
is
well. If you send the documents,
don't think
properly.
About. So let me tell you one secret. I have 9 cavities. So I thought my medical will be rejected because I have 9 cavities. You know what I did? I went to the dental hospital and then I contacted many things like, is my cavities a big problem? No, those type of problems are not very big. Even if you have an eyesight or something, that's not very big. The problems which you are going to think is like, if you come to Korea and then if you have a health issues, if you can't attend the classes like a continuous 1 month, 2 months, those will become counted as a major problems.
For example, if you have any breathing problems, in Korea it generally gets too cold in the month of October, from the month of October. So if you have any breathing problems, you won't be able to survive the cold. Maybe they think, you know, this way. Yeah, not because someone is deceased or something. It's just they care about you a lot.
So
NID does care about you.
So it took us like a 7,000, for me it took us like nearly 8,000 rupees because I did everything in the Apollo. So Apollo is a little bit costly.
And
so.
Got all the documents from different labs. So I did that stupid thing. And also Apollo was wasn't near my year. She was in Bangalore at the time.
Yeah.
She had the opportunity to go to Apollo and then get all thing at a time. I was in some small city in my hometown, so I was not able to do it.
Don't just worry about the medical thing. It's just the physical examination, mm-hmm. chest X-ray, and then the hepatitis, and then
it's basically the general checkup.
Yeah, it's just a general checkup. That's all.
You need the staff and then the doctor's sign. Okay.
Yeah.
Specific doctor's sign.
So if you are going with the dental doctor and then bring in the same copy, get the signature from the dental and then get the signature from the physician, get the signature from the laboratories. That's all. It's nothing. And then the visa. Actually, so we were
the special batch and we had a lot of problems during the visa because we weren't allowed.
Yeah, we are not allowed to go to Korea because of COVID issues in India.
We are from Delta variant, one of the Delta variant countries.
Yeah.
So we were not allowed to come.
So
along with
like
few countries. I think 9 countries in total.
Yeah, 9 countries.
9 countries
in total.
Were not allowed to come to Korea because of this COVID thing.
So
India was in one of the red list.
Mm, yeah. Although all the people who got selected for the round are vaccinated, but still we are not allowed. And then we were like, we had no idea whether we are going in this semester or not. We were literally depressed, so everyone lose their job, like everyone now.
So all of us, everyone were deciding the visa, we were our country was one in the red list. So we were little unluckiest, but we didn't lose hope. We were little depressed because we didn't get the visa by the month of July.
It's already July and our flights are scheduled on August 15th or something. It's end of the July and then we didn't even apply for the visa. And you know the tension, like it's gonna take like 14 days and then how are we going to do? We don't know anything. Like my mom is like, you're going, right?
And the irony is, we have our flight tickets. We have our flight tickets in hand,
Eternity
but
and everything.
We don't have visa.
We don't have visa. And the university is also supported so well. NIED struggled for us. So
NIED,
NIED is like a backbone to us.
It's like, yeah. It's like branch. to us. Yeah. And we all JK scholars, you know, we tried our level best to put emails together.
Yeah.
And then we all were little mutual. I mean, we had mutual interest and then, you know, we worked together to get the visa. And then finally, only the JK scholars were allowed to come to
and
Korea.
And then we went to
India.
Apply for the JK visa in the Chennai. We both applied together. So for the visa documents, you don't need anything except the invitation letter from the GKs. So invitation letter from the GKs, and then the university give you
the
admission letter, and then the
medical.
Yeah, just casual medical, and you don't need a bank statement. Don't worry about the bank statement. Since you're a GKs scholar, you don't need bank statement. That's all, your passport copy and all. So that is the visa, and then the struggles are literally we face so much. We literally feel like, are we not going this time? Are we going after 6 months or something? What are we going to do 6 months? It won't be easy if we learn the language through online or something. So it's literally so hard. And then we applied for the visa. We got it within 14 days. We were about to leave. And then what happened? Again. So it's like we were 50 members. And the people who are going to Seoul only started first. And then reminding people, everyone, actually all 50 students has the flight tickets with everyone, and then they suddenly
visa too,
and then they suddenly before the departure split the dates, like you're like
the people,
they made the people into two groups, and then one group is going first and second group don't know when they are going. It's like you're stepping back, we don't know the reason when we are going. So actually luckily we were in the first batch.
The first batch were, you know, from the list of students
who are going
major
to
universities are in Seoul.
Major universities are in Seoul, or people who are going to language courses in Seoul. Only these people went. But again, due to Emirates issues, my flight got delayed
for one week.
So I was about to leave on 25th of August, but I waited till the 30th of August. It's like 5 days, I think. So it's like, yeah. And then I was literally like, why the hell my flight got changed? I was like, why Emirates, why? And then I had to take the flight from Delhi and then go to Seoul and all. It's a little bit complicated for me.
And another irony is our GK's application, you know, the process and the admission was way more easier than this visa process.
Yeah, that's
way
true.
More easier. It's, I don't know, we were special batch. I'm not sure because of this lockdown and then COVID thing. You know, our batch faced a lot of problems, you know, with this visa and stuff.
So I went to Seoul and then everything was good. During the secondary immigration check, I was rejected. Like, I don't know why. They took me to the secondary investigation. So it's like, I don't know what to say. I don't know anything Korean. I am the only one person. So there are few JK scholars are with me also. Everyone went outside the airport, but I'm still in the airport and then looking for the secondary investigation. And then they're calling many members, like I'm sitting here like this. And then group of 10 Koreans came like this to me. So like, it was like surrounded by me and was like, I don't know what to say. I'm literally, we can't even use mobile phone. And then I just called my coordinator, and then she said something, and then they were like, you're going to stay in the government dormitory, government one. I was like, why I'm going to stay in the government one? I already had the reservation. So it's like,
you should have chose the government one. The government, you know, the quarantine facility was way more better than, you know,
actually, this is also good, but the food is not good.
Dude, they were the government, you know, it's literally a resort. It's a resort, guys.
Sorry, I don't know.
It's a resort. And we were in Ibis in a single room.
Yeah.
With no kitchen stuff or something, anything related to that.
Yeah. So, and then after the big struggles, after 1 year, sorry, 1 month, what the hell I'm talking about? 1 hour. So after 1 hour staying in the airport, extra 1 hour for the secondary inspection and all, so I went out and then I was not able to find the GKs, sorry, NID people. So some government official is taking me for the COVID test. And then I was like, I'm GK, so GKs, this is the name that they gave me. I was literally like that. And then so it was like one person ran to me like, so she's GK students, I can take care of her. So they took care of me and then we got into taxi and then went to quarantine, that's all.
And regarding the money, she actually had the Korean currency?
Quarantine, I can't.
Money exchange?
Exchange. So
regarding the money exchange, she had an HDFC bank account. So
forex card. I took the forex card. So it's way easier. So they're not providing Indian money to direct Korean won any other banks, but HDFC provided Indian money to Korean won directly. So I don't need to pay any other charges. I can directly change my money from one currency to another currency. So it's way easier for me. And also with the cash, I took the cash and I have changed few money in the Delhi airport, and then another few I changed to dollars first.
So you did that?
Yeah.
Oh,
I changed to Indian money to dollars in the Delhi airport. After going to Seoul, I changed my money from American currency to Korean won in the airport. For me.
You can follow my process too. Mine was also simpler. I just went to the SBI. Mine was SBI. I don't have time to get the HDFC bank account. Unlucky fellow. Unlucky me. So I didn't lose hope. I just went to SBI. They gave me a forex card. But don't take forex guys. Card, don't take that card. Just ask them for the dollars. Just take the dollars. And then after coming to this Korean airport, which is Incheon. Yeah, after coming to Incheon airport, I just exchanged the dollars to directly to Korean currency. It was easier for me. I just exchanged it twice, that's all. I got money from the SBI, dollars in dollars, and then I exchanged it at the Incheon airport into Korean won. That's what I did.
So another thing is after how many days we got the statement? So when did you get the statement?
I've reached my university in the month of September, September 7th to be precise, and then I got my stipend on October 5th. So I just spent 450,000 Korean won. Yeah, 450 to 500,000 Korean won. It was like that. I had $400, $450 in my hand. I used that.
So for me, actually, I came to university on September 14th in the Jeju, but I got my allowance in October 20 something. So it's more. So you need some money to take when you're starting from the India. It's like at least the 500,000. $500,000 Korean won is enough for staying, surviving in Korea till you get the allowance. So after getting the allowance, don't spend more. Just spend accordingly whatever you need. There are many. Yes, living here is so costly, but there are many things you can do. Like you can get the things from Daiso, which is cheaper, and then.
And it actually depends upon the place, guys. We were in Jeju, You guys know the Jeju Island is expensive. It's a tourist area, so obviously it's expensive. And the food is also expensive over here. Even the Seoul is, expensive as well. So just be careful. If you are coming to Jeju Island or if you are, residing in Seoul, you have to bring little more money, around 600,000 Korean won. If you are residing in some regional areas, then I don't think it's gonna cost much.
It costs much.
Our friends, they told us 400,000 Korean won was enough for them, literally, for 1 month to survive in Korea without the allowance. So be careful, guys. Spend wisely.
And then bank account, we got it. She got it within a day after you.
It just took 15 minutes.
Yeah, but for me,
they just asked us, whenever you're free, just come to us. We'll make a bank account.
So for me, it took after I had to apply for the ARC first, and after applying the ARC, I got it within 1 day. And then money, after 1 week, I got it.
And
so,
ARC, I got it in 1.5 months. Then after getting ARC, I just connected it to my bank account. That's when I got my debit card. I didn't get my debit card till then.
But for her, I got my alien registration card faster. Immigration office and applied it. That's all.
I don't know what happened with me. It took me 1.5 months. I think I got it in the month of October, October 15 to be precise. And then as soon as I got my ARC, I just got my SIM card. I survived without SIM card.
SIM cards are
costly
here.
And I survived without, SIM card for 1.5 months, guys. There was a special, thing happened. There's a special thing happened during my birthday. I got lost and then I had to walk for almost half an hour because I don't have SIM card and there's no internet because
it happens in Korea.
It happens.
Life without subtitles.
It's not just the subtitles. We were in remote area and there was no one over there literally, and then I don't have an internet
it
access.
Happened to us many times, we almost lost
especially to me. Lives in a downtown, so it's a city area, and then Jeju National University is actually on the top of a mountain. It's actually a little, it's not a countryside, but it's little remote, maybe what to say. the best word to describe it.
It's not remote area, but it's far from the city.
Far from the city. It's like, it's not even the outskirts. It's like no one, you know, stays there. And Jeju National University is so huge.
I really like the Jeju National University, but I like my university more. So that's all about today's video. So I'm going to make a letter of recommendations video, and then the personal statement video, statement of person, and statement of purpose, and also the video about the Dawn Chores vlogs and all. So keep stay tuned.
Until then, bye bye.
Bye bye. Subscribe.